just do two questions based on this. Two charged metallic sphere kept far apart, connected to a thin wire. I assume two spheres A and B, connected to a thin wire. Right? These two spheres are kept. One is carrying charge, say Q1A, and this carries charge Q2. Radius of this sphere is R1. Radius of sphere B, you can take it as R2. Now, what we have to calculate? Total charge will be Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2. Let us consider this. And what will happen when these two metallic spheres are connected to each other? The charge begins to move from one sphere to another sphere, assuming Q1 is greater than Q2. Right? From one metallic sphere to another metallic sphere, and this will be the same as in case of when two bodies, one is at higher temperature, another is at lower temperature, are brought in contact with each other. So temperature, heat energy of higher temperature body gradually decreases, temperature of lower temperature body gradually increases, because the transfer of heat energy from high temperature body to low temperature body, and eventually both the bodies come to a common temperature. The same situation will be here. Since charge of Q1 or potential, if I assume of A is higher than B, then potential charge will flow and eventually both spheres will acquire same potential. So common potential will be KQ1R1, and this will be same in equilibrium. Right? So KQ1 over R1 from equation 1. You can put KQ minus Q1 over R2, K cancels, cross multiply it, what you will get? Q1R1, that is equal to Q1R2, QR1 minus Q1R1, transfer this side, so you will get Q1 is equal to QR1 over R1 plus R2. Similarly, when you put this value of Q1 here, you will get Q2 is equal to QR2 over R1 plus R2. Once we have obtained these values of Q1 and Q2, then use any one formula to find common potential, K 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q1. Value is capital Q R1 over R1 plus R2 into 1 by R1, this R1 cancels. So your answer is 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q over R1 plus R2. So common potential you have obtained. Total charge you can calculate, because now you have the value of Q1 and Q2. So total charge you can say, what is common? Q1 plus Q2 R1 plus R2 Q, you can take common, so it is total charge will be Q only, even if you finally come to this. Let's come to the another question. 8 small droplets are charged by potential difference V. So a small droplet has potential 5 volt, radius I can say is small r. When these are combined, 8 droplets are combined to form a big drop, there will be a change in volume. So from conservation of volume, you can say equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube 8, this cancels. So capital R is equal to 2R. Therefore potential of big drop that will be V big drop K Q over R. K Q is 6 8 Q. No. K Q. Q is how much? Now let us keep Q only. Over R is 2R. Charge will be equal to KQ over R. Charge is conserved, so it will remain same. Oh no, it will, you can say Q value K 8Q over 2R. Q is the charge on a small droplet. So 4 into KQ over R. This is the potential of a small drop. So 4 into 5, that is 20 volts. Is that clear? Let us, I repeat again. 8 small droplets, the total charge on the big droplet will be 8 times the charge on a small droplet. Right? So, let's do one more example. Electric potential at an axial point of electric dipole. This is theoretical. One more example. Example 4. Electric potential at an axial point of an electric dipole. So let's consider electric dipole A, B. Charges, as you know, Q and Q. Separation distance is 2A. Axial point P, distance from the midpoint to the point P is R. Easy to calculate potential due to positive charge at P, then calculate electric potential due to negative charge at point P and add electric potential at P due to positive charge. What will be the answer? VA is equal to KQ over R minus A. Calculate electric potential at P due to negative charge. VB is equal to KQ over R plus A. Therefore, net potential at P, that is VP, is equal to VA plus VB, but this is minus because it's a negative charge. So KQ you can take common, 1 over R minus A minus 1 over R plus A. Solve and take LCM. KQ into 2AR over R square minus A square. Q into 2A is P, so KPR over R square minus A square. This is potential at point P. For short dipole, R is greater than A, then VP is equal to KP over R. Let's do one more exercise. Potential at equatorial point. Equatorial point of a dipole. Consider electric dipole again, distance is 2a, A point, B point, equatorial point, P, if I say AP is R, same figure as we have done in electric field, only the distance, AP is equal to PV is equal to R, so potential at P due to positive charge VA is KQ over R, potential at P due to negative charge, that is VV is equal to minus KQ over R, net potential VP is equal to VA minus VB, this is 0. So at an equatorial point net potential is 0, and in case of axial point it's not a D, not 0. However, at equatorial point you remember electric field is not 0, but electric potential is 0. So there is a possibility at a point when electric field is non-zero and electric potential is 0 for a given system of charges. Relation between electric field and potential. As we know a relation, we have done this relation, which one? We have started with this expression itself. Work done is equal to minus E dr dl. Right? Sorry, Q naught integration. This is termed as line integral of electrostatic field. That is dW, total work done, integration of this. What you have obtained finally, W over Q naught minus E dr. I have not put up the value of this. W over Q naught is basically what? Change in potential difference. That is E is equal to minus dV over dr. This is called potential gradient. So we have got another gradient, that now you can define electric field at a point is also defined as potential gradient of that point, right? Negative sign here shows that the potential decreases in the direction of electric field. This negative sign shows that the potential decreases in the direction of electric field. So you have another SI unit, that is volt per meter. Earlier you have seen Newton per coulomb. So Newton per coulomb and volt per meter both are SI unit for electric field. A small question can be asked on this also, right? Either way, suppose potential example 1, potential at a point varies as V is equal to 3R square minus 2R plus 1. Calculate electric field that R is equal to 1 centimeter. So you find electric field is equal to minus dV over dr. Differentiate it with respect to R, what you will get answer 6R minus 2, 1 is 0. Now put R is equal to 6R minus 2 and then put R is equal to 2, 1, so you will have 4 volt per centimeter. That's how you can calculate electric field for this. But two conceptual questions I also like to discuss here. If at a point electric field is zero, does it mean electric potential zero? Second question, reverse of this, if at a given point potential is zero, does it mean electric field is zero at that point? This we have already discussed in case of electric dipole. Even we have derived both the equations: at equatorial point potential is zero, electric field is non-zero. Now think about this situation. Let's take one more system where four charges are placed at the corners A, B, C, D. All charges are positive charges, right? So minus charge, and these charges are two positive and take two negative. Then total potential at point O will be zero. Total potential at point O will be zero, because this will, if you calculate how much it is, KQ over, suppose this is X, plus KQ over X, minus KQ over X, minus KQ over X is zero. But electric field will not be zero. If I place test charge here, this will attract this side, this will attract, check the electric field. This will attract this side, this attracts this side, this attracts this side, all electric fields, so electric field is also zero. At this system, electric field and potential both are zero. In this system, potential is zero, electric field is non-zero. Right? Now, let's take one example. Plus Q and plus Q charge, midpoint. Distance, this is this X and this is also X. Electric field because of this charge will be this side, how much? A. This side, right hand side. Electric field due to charge B will be towards left hand side. Both electric field EAR is equal to EB. So the net electric field E will be equal to EA minus EB equals to zero. But potential will not be zero. Potential at point P will be potential due to A plus potential due to B. So I have given you all three possibilities. This is here. Sorry, this is here. This is here. This is the example where electric field and potential, everything is zero. Right? So anything can happen. It's not necessary that at a given point, if electric field is zero, potential may not be zero, or potential can be constant. Even you can work it out by this example. See this relation. take one more. E is equal to minus dB over dr. Simple mathematically, if E is 0, it means dB over dr is equal to 0. This means V is constant. That's what actually happens inside hollow conducting a metallic charged sphere. Electric field plays in uniform electric field, right? Electric field inside is zero, but potential is not zero. It is constant throughout, right? Such a region is called electrostatically shielded region. Electrostatically shielded region. So any charge coming in between, there will be no force acted on it. Or this is also popularly known as Faraday's cage. In this situation, if you keep your mobile inside such a case, Faraday case, it is not going to receive any signal. No EMFs are received. That's why it is advised when there is a lightning in the sky and if you are moving a car, prefer or stay inside your car. That will be more safe rather than coming out of the car.